Hello everyone, welcome to the Engineering Projects YouTube channel. In the previous video tutorial, we just configure file in our projects and now we are going to utilize that files. In this video tutorial, our aim is to implement this menu or top bar in our application so that it looks pretty. So we are going to remove this and we're going to implement this right here. But remember one thing, we have already developed a dynamic menu which will help us to show properties or even submenus here, so we can use that too. I have opened this dashboard in Sublime, and from here we can copy the code and paste in layout file of our main project. So first you need to inspect the element to get to know which element is used for header. So we have this begin header and end header. Let me copy this and go here to find that. So from here the header is getting started. If I will collapse this, so I get the header within this. Okay, so now what we need to do, we can create a separate file or partial view to integrate our top bar, or even that we can paste the code same as it is. Copy this and paste in the layout. So go to the layout. Here you can observe the different structure. We have body, and here we will paste the top bar. But before that, we can slightly use this. We have paste that. This is the whole code for the header. Now let me save and refresh the page one. Okay, all the changes are applied but not working because we have messy code regarding the previous style. So we need to remove all the previous style files. So make sure there is no previous style file available here, that will disturb the application, like this. Okay, these all things, so I'm going to commenting them. Now go to the bottom, so there is no file in bottom too. Save this, refresh this, and also we need to remove the previous top bar code, which is this. Okay, and simply this whole code, and it is enclosed here, so we will remove this, or we will remove this whole nav. Comment out this. Now we need to add class, as it is added here. Okay, so in the body we will implement the class. And all the things are available within the wrapper. So we need to develop that wrapper. Okay. So we need to develop this wrapper. And paste all this div under this wrapper. Now we will refresh application once and see in the console. Okay, some files are missing, so we need to enable that files. We can comment this. This too, and all the things are fine. Somehow it's changed, but all the things are not available because these things are not available here. Okay, it's not available. And it's also not available in the script global switch. We need to figure out why these are not working. Okay, so here in the script we need to add plugin, we need to include plugin. So stop the execution, include plugin in the project. When it's get included, then we will again build the project and execute in the browser so that we can verify all the changes which we have implemented are successfully done. And upon that, we can finish this video tutorial. So the basic purpose here is to concatenate the code from the previous video tutorial up to this video tutorial. We have a code of top bar. We already implemented the files. Now we just include that files within our project and execute that code on browser to execute the top bar which we have copy right here. Now we will execute this. Here is the result. Now move on back to the first app, and here you will observe we need layout main CSS. So we will open this in the new tab and copy this CSS file exactly from the folder to our main folder. So it is available in the content folder, which is available content, and here is the layout. So we also need to include here. So stop the execution, include the CSS and also this in the project. Now we need to verify that it is working. Or here in the bottom, it is included or not. Okay, so now we will include that here. Simply we will add that files here from here. We will add all the CSS files. Here we have the plugins. And here we have the themes. Okay. Begin theme global style and theme layout style and theme style. And so we need all these things to be applied there. Copy this and paste here. Now we need to implement something like this content, and there is copy once. Content CSS, and right after CSS we have component and this CSS. Oops, there is a mistake. So we are done. Now we need to apply this. Once we will copy to find out the exact path. Layout. And here in the layout we have CSS and throughout this part. So we need to apply. Like this, and now we will execute in Opera. Now, when we execute the application, and here you will found we have successfully implemented, and these are the images which we don't copy from the source code, so you can replace these images with your own images. Like here you can see we have a user image here, but it's not visible because we don't copy that. But here we have the 404 error for that images. If you will copy paste the images here, you can attach that. I hope this video tutorial is informative. If you have any kind of question regarding this, you can ask us, and don't forget to subscribe to the Engineering Projects YouTube channel. Take care. Bye bye.